Okay, so here this is a defaultly folders like this you will get when you open your software. So here worksheet is there, new worksheet. So create your own worksheet. Okay, so here you can also make changes your name, double click or right click rename you will get. Right click rename your worksheet. So 2G parameters are there. I am entering 2G. So this is a 2G. So now take down the parameters, presentation, WCDMA, radio parameter is there. So adjust in one window, current channel, WCDMA, serving plus neighbors, then presentation, GSM interferences. You will get C by A, presentation GSM interference C by I. Now you can take events, that is signaling events. Then GPS, presentation, positioning, GPS. So this is a GPS, then presentation, positioning, map. So in events, whatever the event is happening, handover, disconnect, attach, handover, call drop, which handover is happening, intracell handover, which from which frequency to which frequency, it is events. Okay, so this one is the map. So in this one the data is already there, so I will remove this data. Okay, so nothing is there here. So the map you will get blank. So here after taking these parameters you have to insert in map database. What database? So this is a database company will provide you. Basis on this you have to do your activity. Okay, so first of all vectors are there. Vectors is nothing but the map. It will be indicate which road is there, where is the street is there. So it will be simply map vector. Then MIPT files is there. So this is the site database which you can open in the map info for information of the site. Map info is another software. Okay, so in upcoming classes I will show you. So then cell file. So this is the cell file, that is a site data information which we are opening in the TAMP software. Okay, then so if you have 2G, 3G, 4G separate MIPTs are there. Site data is separate now, for 2G separate data, 3G separate. So here cell file also 2G separate, 3G separate, 4G separate. Okay, so now see here in map, first of all you have to insert the map. So based on your location area, if you are working in Andhra Pradesh, so Andhra Pradesh data will be provided. If you are working in Karnataka, so Karnataka vectors, Karnataka map. So open here. So here select the location where the data is there. So in the training database, vectors folder are there. So this is all AP vectors. Select this, open. Okay, the map will be open. See here. So this is the vectors of all AP. All AP map, major road, street roads, highways. So Andhra Pradesh vectors, Andhra Pradesh map. So now zoom your location where you are working. So this is Andhra, this is a Hyderabad. Okay. So now the map is there. Then what we need? We need the sites information, no? Where the sites are located. So different operator have different site locations. So here the cell file will be provided you by the company. So if you are working for 2G, so 2G cell file is different, 3G cell file, 4G cell file. So here the cell file folder also is available in the desktop. Okay, cell file. So I am dropping here the 2G cell file. So how to add the cell file here? Go to configuration, general, then cell file load. Enter. Here add is there, remove is there. If you want to remove, you can remove all. So here add, same, select the location where the cell file is located. So cell file folder, this is a 2G cell file. Then okay. So now here the sites will be loaded. So how to identify what is the site is there? Okay, so make the identification label with the cell ID wise. So you can easily identify which site is there. If you label this with the cell ID wise, then you can easily identify which cell is there. Okay, so how to label this? After inserting cell file, here add and edit. So here cell layer, double click. Cell theme, double click, here tick this. So here system is there, GSM, okay. So it will be label all 2G cell file. Okay, so this is the identification of the sites which cell is there, 33091 9293. So this is the sectors, this is the cell IDs. Okay, so after this you can connect the equipments, mobile phone, GPS to the laptop, then connect all. Okay, so make practice in this one parameters. So I will show you how the connection is there, then how the drive test is there. So Monday we go for the drive, so today you can practice this. Okay, so now I will show you one previous old log file. So this is a log file, that is a recorded file. Delay the log file, stop the log file, so it will be recording.
Packet service attached. Call attempt. Call attempt. Call established. Call attempt. Call end. Call established. Handover. Call attempt.
So in this one, RX level is there. What is meant by RX level? RX level is nothing but the coverage level received by the mobile phone. Okay, so here ranges are there. 0 to minus 120 dBm is the ranges of RX level total. So under this, excellent value is there, average value is there, bad value is there. So how? 0 to 65. With this ranges, the mobile will be received, that is the excellent level. And the color code that indicate dark green color indicating. So minus 65 to minus 75, that is a good one, that's indicating with the color green. So minus 75 to minus 85, that is one average, color is yellow. So minus 85 to minus 95, that one is a bad orange color. And minus 95 to minus 120, that is worst, totally red color. So based on this color, you can identify how the coverage levels are there. Okay. So same way, quality is there. So quality value is 0 to 7. 0 to 3. 3 to 5, 5 to 7. This is excellent. That is green color. So average, that is yellow color. This one is a bad, that one is a red color. So this is the quality of the network. So this is a coverage level that you call as a RX level, and RX quality, that is a network quality.